Hi, I'm Linda.
And I'm Julie.
And we are sisters. And we are two of four daughters of David Higginson, who is the creator of David Higginson's professional chord system.
Yeah. David Higginson's professional chord system is a self-instructional course that allows you and me, and you, my sister Linda, to play beautiful chords and beautiful music that we hear on radio and TV every day and play them the way the professionals do.
That's right. We're not doing easy play. We're not doing any of that. These are the real chords that you will hear.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to be playing, teaching you how to play Forever
by Mariah Carey and Walter Afanasoff. One of my favorite songs ever.
It's so good that it's been playing
in my head. And I've been singing it ever since 1996.
That's a long time, and it never gets old.
It never gets old. It's one of those forevers.
So, let's show you how to play.
Okay.
So, should we get started on the song?
Let's go.
All right. I am going to be teaching you the verse. Linda here.
And then Julie here will be teaching the chorus.
Okay. That sounds fair.
Let's go.
Okay. So, the first chord that we'll be learning is an A flat, and then a C with a G bass or C/G, and then an F minor, a D flat, and an E flat.
So just five?
Only five chords for that beautiful,
gorgeous verse. Mm-hmm. And we're just doing the right hand right now, correct?
Yes, that's right. Let's focus on the right hand. So if you are familiar with David Higginson's professional chord system, the right hand of this first A flat, we're just going to be playing the right hand of what is familiar to chord students.
For the basic six note pattern.
Basic six note pattern. So we're going to be playing a C, a E flat, an A flat, and then because of this the rhythm that we're going to teach you, we're going to reach up and do another C. Should we talk about that rhythm first?
Yeah.
Should we show them?
Let's hear how it sounds.
Okay.
Down arpeggio pattern.
It reminds me of a certain time period.
Like the 50s.
Yeah.
This is like a doo-wop.
Yeah, exactly. That's fun. And so, did you say arpeggio kind of like thing? Okay. So just so you know, that's what it's going to be. So that's how you play it. You play the C, the E flat, the A flat with your middle finger, and then you got to reach up here for the other C, which is an octave. So when you reach up to that, you got to kind of let go of this bottom note, okay? I don't even leave my first finger on it, so. Okay, so those are the notes of the A flat.
And you know, when you're playing this rhythm pattern for the first time, don't be impatient with yourself. Just play it over and over again.
It could be this slow at first.
Play it slowly. Don't worry about the speed. And just know that while you're practicing just one chord, you're actually practicing every chord you're going to play with that rhythm pattern. So don't feel
valuable.
The repetition is going to be a good thing, which is definitely always a good plan.
It is. So let's go to the C/G. So this chord is a combination of a C chord and a G chord, but the right hand of it is actually just playing a C triad.
Right. So just a regular every other note C.
Yep. But just like the last one, we're doing an octave of the C again. So if you're playing this first chord, the only notes that change are these two middle notes. Okay. So we actually go.
They just come one step closer
yes.
to each other.
Yeah, that's right. That's a good way to say it. Oops. That one's probably the most awkward position of the song, but it becomes very easy. That's the
yeah. If you can, it's just a little different.
You can do it.
Take on the world.
You can. So you're playing a C, an E, a G, and another C. So you're coming from the A flat chord, and like you said, move these two notes closer. Okay, you can push pause anytime you want to practice these. Now, we're going to talk about the F chord, F minor chord. So, the F minor chord, all we do is move these two middle notes up one note each.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
It's beautiful. I love this.
It is. The chord progression is beautiful and inspiring. So, so that one actually is, if you're familiar with the chord system, It's actually the right hand of what's known as a spread chord. Except when you add the minor, you go like this.
And then we're just hitting that octave
yep.
because we want to do the entire
that rhythm. Pattern. Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay. So then we go to the D flat, which is a regular triad of a D flat chord. So the notes of a triad are D flat, F, and A flat. But we're going to hit another
D flat because we still want to carry on that rhythm pattern.
Yep. So it goes like this. Okay. So the next one is an E flat. So this is also a triad position. There's the E flat triad. But regularly you would play it like this, but because we got to reach up to that note, you change the fingering. So the notes of that are
E flat,
G, B flat, and an E flat. And when you go over your chorus, you can talk about some of the
little tricks,
transition that helps you remember.
Sure.
Okay. So there are the notes of the E flat. Julie is going to name the chords
I'll
as I play it.
Call out the chord when she changes chords.
Okay.
A flat, C slash G, F minor, D flat, E flat.
So here we go with the singing and the chords.
Can't wait.
Those days of love are gone. Our time is through. Still I burn on and on. All of my life only for you. From now until
I teach you the chorus.
Oh, come on.
Yep, it's time.
I did a little mistake, but guess what?
We're just gonna
proceed.
Yeah, maybe use your ear and pick out the part.
That's a good idea. That's why we did it in the first place.
Right. When you're learning these things and you hear them, even when you hear them on the radio, you don't necessarily need a teacher there to slap your hand when you make a mistake. You can tell when you get familiar with these mm-hmm. chords. Okay, so the fun thing about the chorus is it's beautiful, and there are also only 5 total chords in the chorus, and only 1 that you haven't learned already from Linda.
That's so exciting.
It is. The chords in the chorus are A flat, F minor, D flat, D flat minor, that's the new one, and E flat. We're going to start with that becoming ever familiar A flat chord. Right? And all we're going to do next is play an F minor. And I'm just going to tell you what changes in the chord. One little note moves from this to this. Just 2 half steps up. Believe me, those were half steps.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, and so, great. And then keeping these 2 centers, these 2 center notes, we're going to move the C up to the D flat because we're going to play a D flat chord.
That makes it really easy not to have to move those middle notes.
Yeah, they're just grounded there. And then the new chord only moves this first finger from an F to an E. That's the minor part of the D flat chord, and that's the part that just really tears at your heartstrings.
It does.
It's why we keep
very
going
tender.
Back to this song. So then you start again with that A flat, and then move 1 note, and then move the outer 2, and then 1 note down. And then the third time you play that chord chain, we call it a chord chain when we have the same chords played in a row.
Mm-hmm.
This time you play the chord chain 3 times for the chorus, but the last time we're going to play 1 different chord. So the A flat, and then the F minor, then the D flat. And then we're gonna do an E flat, which is one that Linda showed you, which goes basically starting on the E flat, and then this moves down two notes, or up two notes. The next one moves up two notes, and then the, of course, the final one is to an E flat.
Nice.
And then you're ready to play the second chorus. Anyway, yep. So that is the right hand of the chorus. When you're learning these things, really, even if it takes a few days to remember and not, you know, don't throw it all to yourself all at once. Just imagine, does this sound like you are a beginner? No. It sounds like, well, you're playing it the way that Walter Afanasieff.
But we're going to add the left handle, right?
All right.
So we're starting on the A flat. So the bottom hand, all it's going to do is going to be playing octaves, okay?
Yep, so we won't even worry about the right hand right now.
Oh, should we just do the left hand?
Let's just do the left hand.
So A flat, we're going to be playing two A flats, an octave like that.
And you just sit on it.
You sit on it for the duration of the right hand.
Right. Like
playing its rhythm.
One and a, two and a.
And then the next chord is the C with a G bass. So the bass is a G, so we're going to be playing a G to a G, okay?
Lots easier. Not much going on with the left hand.
No. So it's going to add a lot of depth. And then the F minor, you play an F octave. Yep. And then down below to this D flat. Isn't it exciting to play that low on the piano for some of you who have never played before?
I'm excited.
And then finally the E flat. So you play this all through the verse and the chorus.
And you just play it over and over again. The right hand is doing its thing. And something that you might demonstrate is just one chord.
Okay.
The way that you want to practice is just hit left hand at the same time as the thumb.
Okay, yep. So you go like this. Okay.
Just practice that.
Mm-hmm.
And then move on to doing other chords.
And some of them are a little bit quicker movements. That takes a little time, but you'll get it. Just be patient with yourself.
Yeah, so accuracy is way better than speed.
Yep.
The speed comes naturally. Forever by Mariah Carey and Walter Afanasieff.